Michelle, a 9.5% GDP statistic. I want you to frame right now the Bank of America guesstimate of the path from a boom economy to a normal economy. How does that process look?
Sure. And I think that's actually the big question. It's trying, people are trying to figure out what the moderation in growth will look like, because we know that 9, 10% growth, which is what we're tracking in Q2, is not sustainable. So there will be a slowdown, and the data is already indicating that. But it's slowing, you know, in a fairly manageable way, all things considered. So when you look ahead to the next few quarters, we very much believe the economy will be still growing well above trend being close to 2%. So you'll see somewhere in the order of 5, maybe 6% GDP growth on average over the next few quarters. It's half the pace that we had in the second quarter, but we can't imagine the economy will continue to grow at that type of pace, given right. the capacity in the economy.
Dovetail Bank of America sell-side research, your securities research into what you and Ethan are doing in economics. What is the corporate response to the economy you imagine?
Well, I mean, businesses are investing. Businesses are seeing consumers go out and spend. They have cash on hand, and they were actively spending on all things goods up until recently, where there's been some slowing, and now they're really embracing the services side of the economy. But without a doubt, the consumer's out there participating in the economy. And when you see that as a company, you want to go out and invest and meet that demand. And that's very much still what we're seeing in the data flow.
That seems to be what Morgan Stanley's Chet Nia was saying also over the weekend when he says that he expects a red-hot CapEx cycle to sustain global GDP growth above pre-COVID levels. Why is that not necessarily the case as sort of portrayed by the bond market? Or in other words, yeah. how inconsistent is the bond market with some of these projections?
Look, I mean, I know the last few weeks has been all this debate around fundamental and technical factors driving the bond market, but I think beyond that, you know, there seems to be this storyline or sentiment in the market that, yeah, we can have really strong growth for the next few quarters. Fine. That's still part of the payback from this incredibly artificial time in the economy around COVID and the ensuing stimulus. But what's the underlying trend? What's the structural trend? Has that changed? Are we going to return to this environment of slow underlying growth? Are we going to return to an environment where demographics are still quite negative and depressing, where there's still disinflationary psychology? And I think that that's starting to kind of spook the market. You can see in the longer end of the curve.